today's product is wheel cleaning. These are wheels that have come off my 2002 996, which you can see here. These wheels have never been cleaned from the interior. Well, that's not quite true. One of them probably has because it was refinished. So what you see here is just normal accumulation of road, brake dust, and other gunk. What you also see is a bunch of adhesive residue from wheel weights. And because of the design of these types of wheels, these are the Porsche turbo twist wheels, there's lots of little nooks and crannies which make cleaning them actually quite hard. So they look great from the exterior, but from the interior, they don't look great. Here, this one in particular, this is from the front right-hand passenger side. Here's the front driver's side. Now this one looks a lot cleaner because last week I took it off and started to actually clean it. So I used a bunch of the Griot's heavy-duty wheel cleaner with a normal hose pipe sprayer and got them fairly clean. Never really completely got into those nooks and crannies down there and never addressed the adhesive. What I wanted to do was to apply some kind of either wax, sealant or other coating so that it would make the cleanup of this brake dust a lot easier and hopefully without removing the wheels again. I never got to that point, and so for the past week I've driven the car a couple of times up here in the Pacific Northwest where it is rainy, and you know, you can see that there's a fair amount of spatter from the road. I don't really think there's much brake dust here. This one is particularly baked on. So this time I'm going to do the job properly and actually finish it, and that's why I have all of the wheels off the car. And I expect it's going to take quite a while to do each wheel. For the adhesive removal, we're going to try a couple of different approaches. The first is to use Goof Off, and I've measured a bit here into this beaker. And I'm going to use a foam sponge brush type thing, soak it in the Goof Off, and then make sure that I really soak the adhesive very thoroughly. The second method is I'm going to try to use Brake Clean. I've read that this is another mechanism that could work. With both of these, the idea is to leave them to soak into that adhesive, and then to use plastic razor blades or some other non-scratching scraping tool to scrape the stuff off. Let's see if these work, and if not, then I'll go and get some of the 3M adhesive removal, which is also recommended. I'm going to try these two patches here. They look like they're relatively similar, but you can see I've got quite a few to choose from. There's another one down here, and another one, where is it, over here, all on the same wheel. And there's even some down there next to some of the wheel weights that are on there right now, and possibly even here as well. So we'll try these two patches first, and I will start to apply the Goof Off. Get it nice and wet. And I am just going to let that sit there. And then for this one, we'll use the Brake Clean. Make it nice and wet, and we'll let it sit there for about 5 minutes or so and see what happens.
Now it's been about 5 minutes. Let's come back to this adhesive and see what happens. I've got a plastic razor here. So this is the one that we treated with Goo Gone. That's very little difference. Excellent. And this is the one that we treated with Brake Cleaner, and there's very little difference on here as well. Awesome. So, I'll try treating them again, but it looks like we might need to break out something stronger. So now what I've done is to thoroughly drench this in Goo Gone and not let it sit. So remember, this has already had one application of the Goof Off, Goo Gone, whatever it's called,
and I let it dwell for 5 minutes or so now, and presumably that soaked through and then evaporated. And now what I've done is I've applied the goof off again and totally saturated it and immediately started scraping, and now it's come off. Now it's probably still adhesive. In fact, I can feel there's adhesive residue. It's tacky, so I'm going to put some more of the goof off there. Rub it in, and you can see why it's a good idea to wear a glove. And that's it, that's removed. Let's see what happens if we put more brake cleaner in this other one. Start scraping immediately. Well, it's definitely coming off. It does feel like the goof off is being more effective.
Since recording earlier, I picked up some of this 3M adhesive remover.
So I've oriented the wheel vertically. Give this a bit of a spray, get it nice and wet. Certainly seems to be coming off more easily than with the goof off. I suppose the real test would be to apply some of the goof off to this area. Okay, so let's compare. This area is now saturated with the goof off. And it's also coming off pretty well. Well, hard to say. Looks like it's possibly about as effective as the 3M stuff. Let's try putting some of the 3M on. On balance, I think the 3M is a little bit more effective, but certainly seems that the goof off is doing a good job.
So I want to show two things here. The first is we're going to use this Speedy Bright wheel cleaner. It's acidic, it's highly concentrated, and so I have diluted it with one part of the solvent, four parts of water. So I'm going to spray it on to this rear wheel here. You can see it's pretty dirty on the inside. And I'll spray this in on even, being very careful not to inhale it, get it in your eyes, or any of this kind of stuff. This is an acidic solution. Alright, so I'm going to use one of my wheel scrub brushes here and start to agitate, and you'll see that, you know, it's coming off, doing a pretty good job. But you might remember that earlier I was using the 3M adhesive remover to remove some of the adhesive from old wheel weights, and I didn't clean the wheel beforehand, and that was a big mistake. Reason being that the 3M adhesive does drip, even though I was pretty careful doing it, and because it dissolves the adhesive, when it drips it takes the adhesive with it, and what you end up having is streaks of the adhesive all over the place, including on the face of the wheel, which obviously you don't want. So then the only way that I was able to remedy that once the wheel was clean was to spray some of the 3M adhesive solvent onto a microfiber towel, and then go over the wheel thoroughly and make sure that I got every trace of the adhesive off. So that was an extra step that I wouldn't have needed to do had I made sure that the wheel was clean to start off with. So, okay, this is now sprayed on. It's dwelled for a bit. So let's use the sprayer to get rid of it. Okay, and what you'll see, especially in this area right here, is an example where this is adhesive that has been dissolved and carried away by the solvent. So what I can now do is to take my microfiber, put some of the adhesive remover on it, and go over that area, and you'll see that it becomes clean.
So this is what we end up with after using the wheel cleaner and also the 3M adhesive remover. On this one in particular, it looks like this wheel had a run-in with some tar. You can see there's this really black stuff here, and it's just, you know, stuck on, does not want to come off. I was able to get some of it off by using some of our old friend, the 3M adhesive remover, works on tar as well. I think I'll try and hit it again tomorrow. You can actually see that there's it has thickness. It's definitely, it's either rubber or tar, and I suspect it's probably tar. Anyway, it does come off, but it, you know, needs to be soaked, and I needed to use a trim tool, plastic trim tool, to actually remove what I could. So I'll give it a go tomorrow, see what happens, see if I can get some of it off. But I also went over these little channels, and pretty much about as clean as I can get them right now. So I think we're ready for the next step. And you can see the front face of the wheels is pretty clean as well. I went over them with a microfiber. What I didn't do a great job of is these areas here where the lug nuts go. This one's actually not too bad. This one probably could do with a bit more cleaning, so I'll just go around it, you know, so, yeah, tomorrow as I finish up. What I'm doing now is I'm taking each wheel. I have wet it thoroughly just with water, and I sprayed Iron X, which is going to change colour, as you can see here, and it's dissolving any iron deposits. The reason why we've got so many on this one is that you can see that those interior nooks and crannies are still pretty dirty. So what I'm going to do to attach those is to take a microfiber towel and then put this trim tool inside the microfiber tool, so I can get a really good edge in that microfiber towel and start to attack those nooks and crannies. So this is what it looks like after I've gone over it with the microfiber towel and the trim tool. See that it looks quite a bit better. For these areas I tend to go like this, really try to work that in, but it's hard. So now this is the cleaned wheel, which has been rinsed off. So you can see that there is still a little bit of tar. I'm not going to worry about that. I think it's pretty clean. And you can see there's a few pock marks down here, which I assume are from stones that got kicked up. And these have actually gone through the paint and are marring the surface. Now the wheels are clean and they're dry as well. I've also gone in and really wiped down these interior pieces here where the recesses for the lug nuts, and because they're difficult to get clean. Now on this one in particular,
you can see that there are some blemishes to the surface. And what I'm going to do now is to use specifically formulated wheel cleaning clay, which is a harder compound than normal wheel cleaning clay. Just looks like this. And some speed shine. So when claying the wheels, just make sure that you've got enough of the lubricant on the surface, and then you just gently go over it with the clay. Now these wheels obviously have a lot of folds and so on and so forth, so you know, you want to make sure that the surface is nice and wet so that you're not dragging the clay over it. If it's sticking, then it's time to apply some more lubrication. And you know, you'll see that this started off as being bright white with no marks on it, and you know, you can start to see that it's a little bit grayer now. We've pulled away some of the surface contaminants. You want to make sure that it's nice and malleable. Another good tip is to make sure that you've got, which I don't have here, some of the speed shine or lubricant on the glove, otherwise the clay will stick. And keep folding it. Here's the previous side that I used, and you can see some gunk in there. So once this clay is, once you've used the clay, that's it, get rid of it, use a new piece if you're doing wheels in the future. Now we're on to the last few steps. So the first step is going to be to use a machine compound. I'm using Griot's complete compound here, which is, I guess, is kind of a medium aggressive type of compound. They used to have machine polish 1, 2, 3, etc. They've changed their naming conventions. Anyway, I'll start with this. This is going to, on the wheel face, I'm only going to bother with the wheel face here. And this will remove the worst of the imperfections and swirls. We'll use this orange machine applicator pad. So this is a high density foam on a 3-inch orbital. And then I'll use a high gloss super fine polish. So this is the Reflect polish by CarPro, but you could use any other final type of polish. Then I will finish it off with liquid polywax, and we'll use a different softer applicator to do that. This is really going to give a nice protective coat finish. And then finally we will use CarPro Hydro 2. And this is similar to a sealant type of thing. So you might have heard of sea quartz, which I've used, haven't been super impressed with, but I think that was user error more than anything else. But essentially we'll get the wheel wet, and then we will spray diluted. This actually needs to get diluted 1 to 6, which is why I've got the little measuring beaker here. We'll spray the diluted Hydro 2 on the wet wheel, and this is going to form a coating that will be hydrophobic, so water should just, you know, be afraid of this coating, and that will hopefully keep the wheels clean and easier to clean in the future. So we'll start with a complete compound. What I'll do is I'm going to show you the before on this wheel, so you can see that there's some stuff here that, when I run my finger over it, I don't actually feel any raised aspects of it. So it's definitely suitable for polishing. You can see there's a bit down here as well. So we'll go over it with the polish. Okay, so we'll machine polish this wheel. You'll see it's now sunny. However, this being the Seattle area, it isn't exactly warm. This wheel is about 50 degrees Fahrenheit, 10 degrees centigrade in terms of temperature, so it is perfectly safe to polish. So we're going to put a bit of the polish on the applicator pad, work it in, and I'm going to choose a low setting to start with, 2 on this one. And just start to work the polish in everywhere. So I'm going to raise the speed here.
5 and really go over the area where I've had the imperfection before.
Okay, let's see what that looks like. So, microfiber, and if we can come in for a close-up here, we'll see nothing at all, which is exactly what we want, so that imperfection is gone. Now, there was an imperfection here, and it looks like that got polished away as well.
These wheels have all been compounded now. I did, in the end, do the interiors as well, the barrels, and specifically around the interior face, because, you know, if you look,
you can definitely see that plenty of that barrel is going to be exposed when it's on the car. So I wanted to make sure that I got, you know, imperfections off, and then I can polish it and apply the protective wax, and then finally the Hydro 2 stuff. So
now we're going to apply the polish. So I'm just going to polish each one using the same type of correcting pad. I've cleaned this correcting pad. And the way that I cleaned it was, first of all, I got as much product out by spinning the pad and applying a compressed air jet to it. Then I took the pad off, washed it with dish soap, and, you know, washed it, rinsed it a few times, squeezed it out, and then dried it by turning it on and spinning it, and obviously that centrifugal force gets all of the water out, and also applied some more compressed air. So that's pretty dry now, and I can just reuse it, or I could use a new pad, but I'm just going to reuse this one. So we'll apply, I shook this polish up, we'll apply a little bit of it, work it into the pad, and then I will apply it at a low speed to the wheels. So this wheel has now been polished, and you can see that there are still some blemishes. So this one here is actually damaged to the rim. This one is actually in the paint, in the clear coat. Here's another one where, you know, this looks like this is something that could have been removed, but actually it's also, you know, in the clear coat and is, you know, sealed in at this point. So I would suspect that the only way to really get rid of this one is to refinish the wheel, or at least sand it more aggressively, which I don't really want to do at this point. Here, this was looks like a piece of hair. It's actually a scratch, and it, you know, was a lot worse before, but I can actually feel that this is now also in the clear coat. It's possible that with some more aggressive compounding I could get rid of it, but you know what, it's good enough for me at this point. And then I've also polished the interiors, which interior of the barrel that you can't really see terribly well here. But what it means is that when I seal everything, it'll hopefully keep everything a little bit cleaner, and you can see there's still, there is no more adhesive here. However, the adhesive has actually discolored the rest of the wheel. So, you know, it's, while it's not sticky and there's no level difference or anything like that, it is now a different finish to the rest of the wheel. And I suspect the only way to really address this would be to repaint the wheels. Now we're at the last machine stage. So I've switched pads. We've now got a soft foam pad, and we're using the liquid poly wax. So this is a wax, it's a synthetic wax, and what we're going to do is to apply it, you know, to all over the wheel. So the outside, and especially in this case the wheel well, because this is going to help, I hope, repel brake dust and so on. Now this stuff needs to sit to cure for about 10 to 30 minutes, it says. I'm probably going to go with 30 minutes just because it's fairly cool here. In addition to putting the wax on the face of the wheel and the barrel of the wheel, the interior, what I'm going to do is to put a bit of the wax on the tip of my finger and actually work it in to these areas, which
you just can't really get to any other way. Because, again, the whole point of this wax is to stop the accumulation, or at least make the brake dust less prone to sticking, and we'll hopefully be able to get the brake dust out of here more easily, and other road dust and so on, with the protective wax coating. I'm preparing the Hydro 2, so this actually needs to get diluted 1:6, so I've got 240 millilitres of water, distilled water, and then 40 millilitres of the Hydro X, which I'm going to combine together in a sprayer, and I think that should give me probably about the sprayer to be half full, which is fine for what I need right now.
Okay, so I'm going to get these wheels wet. Just lightly spray them with water, and then we'll apply the Hydro 2. And they say to apply it out with not in direct sunlight, so that's why it's in the shade. And the technique is to do a light coating and then rinse it off. So prime this thing. Okay, here we go. You want to come around here? See the interior. And now we will rinse it off.
Ultrasonic process is going to strip absolutely everything off these, and I want to have a coating on there that's going to promote corrosion, that's going to prevent rather corrosion. I have removed the one of the wheel lug nuts. I want you to see the difference. This is one that has just come out of the ultrasonic bath, and this is one that is from one of the other wheels, so it's untreated right now. So you can see there's, you know, some build up here. It's not terrible. You can see some on the threads as well, and you can see that this one is just a lot better.
While the lug nuts are in the ultrasonic bath, I'm going to prepare the acid cleaner. This is an organic acid that needs to be diluted 1:4. The ultrasonic bath will loosen surface deposits, but this chemical, together with light scrubbing with a brush, will get them clean.
This is the set of lug nuts that I've left immersed in the acid bath, and you can see down at the bottom the accumulation of gunk, and when these actually get removed, I scrub them with a brush and then I thoroughly give them a rinse. Right, so this one has been in the acid bath, scrubbed it a little bit with a brush, and then I rinsed it off very thoroughly with water. So this is actually very clean. You can see there's still a bunch of marks on here, but these are actually scrapes from the impact wrench and, you know, whatever was used to actually take the wheel lug off and to put it back on again. This is one that's just come out of the ultrasonic bath with no treatment with the acid wash. And then this is one that's actually just come off on the rear, one of the rear wheels. That actually looks surprisingly good. This is the final step with these lug nuts. I have rinsed them and I have dried them. Now you'll see that they have this movable piece right here, sort of collet. It's important that this is down so that you have access to the bolt shaft. I'm going to spray this protectant. Turn it around, and as I said, these have been thoroughly rinsed with water to remove the wheel acid bath, and then dried as well. I've mounted the wheels back on the car now, and I've just finger tightened the lug nuts. I'll
then tighten it with a torque wrench to the appropriate amount, and take the opportunity to put the emblems back on. So I do that all around. I took the opportunity to check the tire pressures and get them up to the correct amounts. And when the car's back on the ground, I can apply some of the tire shine. Obviously, I didn't want to do that while I was trying to get the wheels back on the car, because that would make it quite slippery, and I'm sure I'd get black fingerprints all over the alloys. I hope you found this useful, and over time we'll see how well the polywax and the Hydro 2 coating does its job in keeping these wheels a little bit easier to maintain. Thanks for watching.